Hi, I'm Swarupa Sail, course instructor for Geotechnical Engineering 1. In this presentation, we will learn how to find out coefficient of consolidation CV, which gives us the rate of consolidation by using one of the method called square root of time fitting method. We know that clay soils undergo consolidation settlement under the action of external loads, which are called as surcharge loads, and also under its own weight. And even when weight of soils which exist above the clay, which is called as geostatic loads, there will be consolidation settlement observed in the soil sample. And even when the soil is dewatered, that is when groundwater is pumped out from the soil sample, the effective stress on the clay increases, due to which there will be consolidation settlement. Coarse grain soils do not undergo consolidation settlement due to high hydraulic conductivity compared to fine grain soils, that is clayey soils. Instead, coarse grain soils undergo immediate settlement. Consolidation test is conducted to obtain soil data, which is used in predicting the rate and amount of settlement of structures constructed on clay. And coefficient of consolidation is a measure of the rate at which the consolidation process proceeds. And it is also called as rate of compression under a load increment. Here we can see a plot of voids ratio E versus log of effective stress, that is sigma dash. During the initial stages, that is at low effective stress, sample follows recompression path, which is shown by portion AB. And here there will be less compression. Beyond this point is the virgin compression line, which is shown by portion BC. And this is also called as normal compression line. And here the soil sample undergoes large compression. BC is also called as virgin compression curve or normal consolidation line, that is NCL. From point C, when the sample is unloaded, sample expands and follows the path CD, which is called as expansion curve. The sample undergoes permanent strain due to irreversible soil structure. So here we can see permanent deformation shown on the graph. The deformation recovered is due to elastic rebound, and there is small elastic recovery, which is shown on the graph. And when the sample is reloaded, the reloading curve lies above the rebound curve, and there will be a loop which is formed between the expansion and reloading curves. The reloaded soil shows less compression, and loading beyond point C makes the curve to merge smoothly into portion EF as if the soil is not unloaded. CV is evaluated from consolidation test data by using the characteristics of the theoretical relationship between the time factor and the degree of consolidation. Such methods are called fitting methods, as they involve fitting in the characteristics of the theoretical curve with the experimental curve. The similarity between the laboratory curve and the theoretical curve is used for finding the coefficient of consolidation CV. A plot between the time factor and the degree of consolidation resembles the time compression curve for clays. The coefficient of consolidation CV is found using two graphical procedures, which are called as fitting methods. First one is square root of time fitting method, and second one is logarithm of time fitting method. In square root fitting method, a plot is made between dial gradings and square root of time at constant load, and the time corresponding to 90% consolidation is found out. Here we can see a plot which is drawn with the values of deformation which are shown on y-axis and square root of time t on x-axis. There is a curve shown over here. We need to draw a line AB through the early portion of the curve. Later on, again one more line which is AC to be drawn such that OC is equal to 1.15 times the distance OB. The abscissa of point D, which is the intersection of AC and the consolidation curve, gives the square root of time for 90% consolidation. So here we can see square root of t 90 being shown on x-axis. The quotient of consolidation for any degree of consolidation can be obtained from the graph. Now, the quotient of consolidation can be found using formula Cv is equal to Tv into h square divided by t. Tv is the time factor for degree of consolidation equal to 90%. So, it is Tv 90 into h square divided by t 90. Cv is in terms of centimeter square per second. For 90% average degree of consolidation, time factor is equal to 0.848. So, Cv is equal to 0.848 into h square divided by t 90, where h is equal to height of drainage at u equal to 90% and t 90 is time at u equal to 90%. Thank you.